Good morning, my dear lovely students. Welcome back to my channel once again. I'm your science teacher, Ms. Zainab Khan. Kids, I'm really very glad to see you once again on this virtual platform. And you know that we are conducting online classes on a regular basis. And we teachers are really very happy to teach you in different manner. And we really hope that you all are enjoying too. So kids, without wasting any time, just like my video, subscribe my channel if you are new, and hit the bell icon for latest notifications, right? Okay, and quickly mention your name, class and section in the chat box for your attendance. Okay, so I want to ask something from all of you. Name two things which you cannot live without and you find it really of great importance in your life. Think and tell me the answer. Any two things you can't live without. Somebody will say, I can't live without my parents. Someone will say, I can't live without my toy. Somebody will say, I can't live without my dress. And many more things. But what is the main answer? Our chapter is all about this. Think according to science point of view. Our basic necessity, which we cannot live without. Yes. This is our chapter number 2 from book 5, term 2, air and water. Yes, kids, we cannot live without air and water at all. But our first priority is air. We cannot imagine our life without air. We can live without water for few hours, but without air, we cannot live even for a single second. No doubt, we can hold our breath for few seconds. But we cannot imagine our life without air. This is the reality of every living being. And living being includes human beings, plants, animals, etc. Okay? So first of all, we'll deal with the topic air. And then afterwards in our upcoming classes, we'll study about water. So let's zoom in and discover more about air. Air is our first and basic necessity of life. We as a human can't live without air and water. But we need to study about air. As we all know that air is very essential for our survival and all living things need air to live in this world. Humans and animals, of course, inhale oxygen and they exhale carbon dioxide. However, plants need carbon dioxide to carry out the process known as photosynthesis. Means they make their own food with the help of carbon dioxide. But what is air? Air is a mixture of invisible gases and particles, each with their own properties. Air is different. It is a mixture of different gases which we can't see with our eyes, which is not visible to us. But in your higher grades, you'll be able to classify different types of air. But as per your standard, you will study about nitrogen, oxygen and carbon dioxide. So air is the most important thing in our life. We must need air for our survival. Here you can see different examples. Air helps to dry clothes. It helps in flying kites in the sky. It helps boats to sail and rest. Other plants take in carbon dioxide with the help of air only. And rest are the example of water. So air at any cost is important for us. And as a human, we must protect our air in a very proper manner. Here are the uses of air. Plants and animals need air to live. Humans need air to breathe. Birds fly because there is air. Air is needed for burning. We fill air in balloons, footballs and cycle tires. Air is used to move things like kite, helicopter, sailboat and windmill. So in all the aspects of our life, air is equally important. Kids, to improve the quality of air, we must plant more and more trees in our surroundings to have fresh air. We cannot afford air pollution because air is polluting day by day. So we must plant few trees to make our air very fresh. Now here you can see the image of composition of air. Air comprises of different gases. For example, this blue portion is of 78%, which contains nitrogen. Green one is your oxygen, which contains 20.9, that is approximately 21% of oxygen, and the rest others are your carbon dioxide and different gases. So nitrogen is most important. It is also helpful in for the growth of plants, and it is added to the soil by the way of fertilizers. Oxygen is important for breathing in. Carbon dioxide is important for plants to prepare their food in the presence of sunlight, water. Okay, so in all the aspects, nitrogen plus oxygen plus carbon dioxide, all the three gases are very important for us. Now you can see oxygen cycle on earth. See, green plants, they provide us atmospheric oxygen, and then it is helpful for the human. We breathe in oxygen, your plants, your animals and humans, as we breathe in oxygen, and in terms we breathe out carbon dioxide, which helps again plants to absorb the carbon dioxide, and they perform very important essential process that is known as photosynthesis, and they make their own food, and again they produce oxygen for us. That's why we are advised to save plants, save trees, just for our benefit, for our sake, not for we must think for the plants as well, because if we will keep our plants in a good and better position, then only we'll be able to have good oxygen for us. Okay, likewise carbon dioxide, that is known as CO2 also, it is also very essential for everyone, because if plants will not get carbon dioxide, then they won't be able to make their own food, and we won't be able to get anything from the plants. So this is the process of carbon dioxide. As a human, as a living being, we give carbon dioxide, we exhale carbon dioxide for the process of photosynthesis, just for the plants only. That's why plants are able to absorb carbon dioxide, and they make their own food, and then they provide us with different varieties of materials which they can. Kids, this is a very fine introduction of your chapter Air and Water, wherein we discussed more about air. So today we have started the topic air, and I really believe that you understood the topic very well, wherein we discussed about what is air, what are the uses of air, why air is essential for the survival of human beings and for all the living things. So what you have to do, just observe your surroundings, pick out few examples of air, related to air. For example, your kite, you have just studied in your video, and many more other examples I want you to write down in the comment box below. And one more homework for you, that you need to draw a well-labeled diagram of composition of air in your rough copy, just for the practice purpose, because this diagram will enhance your thinking regarding the differentiation of various gases. Okay, so learn the diagram, make it on a rough copy, and till then, stay healthy, stay safe, revise the classwork, do not miss your regular online classes, and take care. Goodbye.